A man dreams one day to fly. A man takes his rocket ship into the skies. He lives on a star that's dying in the night and follows in the trail the scatter of light.
Commander Frank DeWitt of the International Space Station, thank you for joining us this evening. Stay calm.
We're just trying to do a simple thing, which is remind people back on Earth that the impossible is possible.
Zooming in.
Zooming out.
Nothing I can't do without.
A lens to see it all up close, to magnify what no one knows.
Never in company.
Never alone.
No car alarm.
No cellular phone.
International Space Station up there.
This is Expedition 20. We're happy to hear your voices, guys.
This is really, really incredible. We're so moved that you would take some time out of your schedule.
Well, we're working for the benefit of humankind, and we're trying to work for the future.
Well, that is great. Are you excited about the future, Colonel Fidelka?
We have 100% of certainty that everything will be very great with your help and with our help in space, guys. We need to work together on the ground and in space and everywhere where humankind is supposed to be.
Every hour and a half, the International Space Station goes around the world. They're asleep now. Their geosynchronous rhythms would have them asleep, but they left us a message earlier. It's a little short message, so I'm going to try and see if we can get in touch now. Let me see. Here you go. I asked them for a message for Dublin, for Croke Park.
Hello, Croke Park. We hear the boys are back in town.
Hello, Dublin. What's the crack? You all having a good night?
And I asked them also for if they have one special message for us at Croke Park tonight. Future needs a big kiss. Thank you all.
Establish that you're weightless, that's a good thing. Anything that explains to the audience that this is not a studio. So many extraordinary people have led the mission to explore space. Great scientists, really heroes. International Space Station, coming out of NASA, Russia, all over. You're the first artist in space, and that really connects with the crowd here. and with me personally. We've got something very special for you tonight, Tampa. We're hooking ourselves into this worldwide event that's going on tonight, an out of this world event, actually, because while we're here playing rock and roll, our friend Guy La Liberté, who was the founder of Cirque du Soleil, he is orbiting the earth. And for his mission, he's on a mission to talk about how precious water is on the planet. And we love Guy.
I'm telling you.
Here he is.
First of all, hi Tampa, hi Ben, hi you two, hi everybody. So happy to be here. It's still great. This is an amazing experience. I'm so glad to be here.
Well, tell me this, Guy, what has it been like? What's the weightless stuff? What are you learning up in space? What's happening up there? Can you hear me, Guy?
Well, first of all, I'm learning how to float. I'm learning how this fantastic adventure and space station is functioning. And plus, I'm preparing and I'm doing tonight my poetic social mission. I'm so happy that you guys are participating in it.
Well, you are the first clown in space, and we think it's a great idea for you to give us your perspective on our little planet while you're not on our little planet and instead looking down on it. And how do we look from here? How does our little planet look, Guy?
Well, I will tell you, every time that I look downstairs, I see a fantastic planet. The blue of it, when there's cloud, sunrise, sunset, there's amazing image. Sometimes you see the moon and earth at the same time in a perspective that we cannot see. And I'm looking all around me. I see stars, I see darkness, I see emptiness. And you know what? Planet Earth looks so great, but also so fragile. So this is today is a tribute to Earth, and I'm telling you, you're looking great, and we should not forget that we have a great privilege to live on planet Earth, that's for sure.
Thank you, Guy. Guy La Liberté, first clown in space. Safe trip, safe home, Guy. So let's get for our liftoff here. Are you ready for liftoff, Tampa? Going up! Going up!
Liftoff of the Space Shuttle Discovery, returning to the space station, paving the way for future missions beyond.
Them talking.
Okay, Capcom, go to the video and do a 10 count video.
Two of these, thanks so much.
In fact, we got that count, we'd like another count with the
video. Is there just one phone?
There's still one. Men Frank, it's Bono the Edge and a couple of troublemakers calling space.
They enable?
I want to ask the crew of the ISS, was it different having an artist other than an engineer or a scientist with you? How did he behave?
He was a big professional up here. He did very well. We all enjoyed it thoroughly. But of course, we don't usually run around with red noses, and he did. So it was a change for us, for sure.
It was very fun. It was really nice to have him here, and it was nice to have a different perspective on the whole space thing. We all really appreciate how beautiful the planet is, and try as much as possible to look out the window. But it's always nice to see somebody who has a little different perspective come up here and share it with us as well.
We've had our breath taken away this morning to be let in here into this place. It is an amazing church of possibilities, and that you represent. So we're here to pay homage and thank you for your time.
addresses pass.
So what do you think of our little space station then? I mean, we feel right at home here in Houston. Home. Home of space stations. And the home of space exploration is a great feeling. And we want to thank all our friends at NASA who made an incredible effort to make our show better.
I hear your music on Earth and it reminds me of what I've seen in space, which really is a gift that you've given us, because the scenes that we see go really well with your music.
We saw you last night. We were getting in the car to go home, and my wife turned to me and said, after meeting you guys, said, you know, all that worrying that we have and stress we have, when you strap yourself on top of the rocket, is now worth it. So with you guys. So there's no other gift that you could give to us that we can repay you with.
So we have something, a small token for you.
Yeah, there's all I couldn't believe that we were giving you one of these. We only give out a very few of these. There's only a couple of them. Presidents of the United States have them.
And you.
That is awesome.
So,
I really,
give
really,
them
really enjoy it.
These are heroes to us. So, to you, they're just next door neighbors. To us, they're heroes. Let me introduce you to our captain, The Edge. Our chief flight engineer, Larry Mullen. Very own space walker, Adam Clayton, on the base. Houston, we have no problem. So much more to ask of you and ourselves.
We will set far-reaching milestones, and step by step, we will push the boundaries, not only of where we can go, but what we can do.